At Dallas Comic Con with John DeLancie, standing here as plain as the nose on my primate face. He is, of course, Q from Star Trek The Next Generation, Colonel Simmons from Stargate SG-1, and most recently, I think, Discord from My Little Pony. And, right. And there's a new
Friendship
project.
Friendship is magic.
Friendship is magic. And there's a new project that you're involved with that revolves around that, that's on Kickstarter. What can you tell me about that?
I sort of stepped into this world and completely having no idea what it was that I was getting into, and I have become absolutely enthralled with the people, enthralled with what it is that they're trying to do, and I just thought that through my eyes of somebody who's kind of a total newbie to this, we could create a documentary which takes all of us, the larger population, into a world which is really made up of very good people doing good things.
And the project's called Pronycon.
No. It's Brony.
Bronycon. Bronycon. Right, okay. Right. So I'm putting pony and brony together.
Right, right.
So Pronycon, the project is on Kickstarter.
The project is on Kickstarter right now, and we have, I think, about 2 more weeks to go. And we started out sort of thinking that it was going to be a modest project, but as the time has gone on, very quickly, in other words, in just a matter of a week, we have discovered and so many more things. I mean, you know, bronies are all over. I get emails from the Ukraine, from Israel, from Saudi Arabia. It's a really fascinating and fast-moving fandom that is being created, and one of the things which, when Star Trek brought in a lot of people who were interested in science and fiction and computers and stuff like that. This fandom are people who are interested in art and music. Well, I'm interested in art and music. As a matter of fact, I've spent my entire life in art and music, as it were. So I think that before the unfortunate media brands them or tries to essentially make fun of them, I think that they need to identify themselves. So this is not me making a documentary about me, it's bronies making a documentary about themselves, and I'm sort of the facilitator.
Now, is this going to be anything like Denise Crosby's Trekkies documentaries or along those same lines in terms of tone, or is this going to be more just an informational type of project? Here's what the bronies are all about.
Well, I'd like to say that it's going to be respectful, insightful, and entertaining.
You mentioned being a musician. Your father was a musician. Mm. You have done a project with Robert Picardo, Star Trek the Music.
Right.
I was talking with him in St. Louis at the Star Trek exhibition out there, and we were talking about the lack of space-based science fiction shows on TV right now. And you mentioned Star Trek creating an interest in science and math and that sort of thing. What kind of impact do you think that we're seeing in fandom now that most of our science fiction on the air right now is fairy tale based? We don't have anything set in space. Do you think is that going to hurt any interest in science and math and engineering for the future generations?
Well, that's a really interesting question. I mean, I know I've had a lot of people who told me that they got into science, and they're, you know, close to my age, because of Star Trek. I'm not as fantasy-oriented as I am hard science-oriented. So I tend not to watch those shows. So perhaps it will have an influence. I think that we also have a situation right now where the world has become so unpleasant, and even in our political arena right now, everything has to be so demonized and what have you, that people are moving a little bit towards fantasy, because they're just like, God, this world. I mean, at least I can live in my mind in a happier place than where we exist now. But what What it will do to the science-based people, I'm not sure.
Do you think that the current political environment and social environment is one of the reasons why the My Little Pony project has picked up so much attention and interest so quickly?
Well, it is for me. It is for me. I'm really appalled by the way in which the political climate is. I really feel that we are all in the same boat. We are all in the same country, and we have problems that need to be fixed by everyone. And that it isn't this tug and pull between two different parties and what have you, the ridiculing and actually the truth is in the end has become sort of the victim of all of this. So I'm really upset about that. And while I can't really do very much about it from a political point of view, I don't think I can do something about it in terms of these people who have created a fandom. The things that they espoused and the things in the way they behave is very good. I saw some media on them that was really insulting and assaultive, and I just thought, oh no. That's just maybe I can help in that respect.
So, John DeLancie is not going to be running for office anytime soon, is that right?
No. Okay. I'm going to be running off on my boat to the South Seas. That's where I spent. That's my fantasy land.
That's it.
Yeah, that's okay. My fantasy land.
Last question. I'm going to let you get to your fans and autographs here. When are we? Now, notice I'm not going to ask you a yes or no question here.
Okay.
When are we going to get another Alien Voices production?
Oh, Leonard and I are not going to do any more Alien Voices. We had a wonderful time while we were doing them. They ended up becoming like anything else. You create a widget and then you have to sell it. And we weren't really in the business of selling. That's just not quite what we do. There are people out there who do it much better than Leonard or me. So that sort of stopped us after a while. We looked at each other one day and we just went, do I really want to go sell audio tapes? No, I want to create audio tapes and I want them to do well, but I don't want to be hawking audio tapes. So we stopped. There will be soon another avenue of creativity. I don't know if it'll be between Leonard and me, but he has his photography and I now have this documentary. I'm good for about 3 to 4 to 5 months of heavy concentration, and then I sort of want to move on. Alien Voices was 4 years, and we did a good job. And you can I put them online, so you can go and get them now. Alienvoices.net, and you can download them. And I did for teachers. I did a show. I did a for Halloween, I did The Raven by Edgar Allan Poe
on
YouTube.
That was a wonderful reading of that.
Thanks.
Now, would you be open to anybody else picking up the Alien Voices and running with it? Is that something that you guys have talked about, maybe letting somebody else do it for a while?
Yes. Well, actually, the answer is yes. One of the things is that people want to buy it completely. They want to say, well, we'll give you X amount of money and then we essentially own them. And I've never really wanted to have that happen. So if somebody wanted to be, you know, an agent for them and spend their time, I'm more than happy to share with them the profits of what they make, but not to just give them away that way.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, the new project is BronyCon. It is a documentary that's raising money now on Kickstarter. You can find the link here in the video. John DeLancie, thank you very much for your time today.
Really great questions. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. And you can find all the latest science fiction news at scififorme.com. Get social with us on Twitter and Facebook.